This is Wanda Adams, your HISD president. I am so excited to be right here on the campus of Westbury High School, and I want to thank you for joining us on The Yard. We have some dynamic guests with us this morning to talk about the Go Center. The Go Center was created and organized by the wonderful staff right here at Westbury High School to encourage all of our students who want to walk the walls of high school to be able to want to walk the walls in college. So I want to introduce you to our guest that's with us this morning. We have Ms. Ashley Glenn, who's the College Success Advisor. Good morning, Ms. Ashley. And also we have Ms. Laura Dew, who's the College Access Coordinator.
Good morning.
Along with what I consider as one of the best principals in HISD, and don't tell the other principals I said that, Ms. Susan Monahan.
Good morning, Ms.
Along with Ms. Susan Monahan and Ms. Taylor Turner, who's the advisor for Texas Advisor. Is that the correct title?
Yes,
of that?
Ma'am.
All right. So they're joining us this morning on The Yard, and we're going to talk about all the great things that they do in the Go Center. First of all, Ms. Dew, I want to go ahead and start with you. Tell us why you think the Go Center is so important right here on the campus of Westbury High School.
So we have a lot of students whose families have not been to college, so they're considered first generation students, and they lack information about what they need to do in order to go to college. So we walk them through every step of the process, from thinking about where to go to college and where to apply, the applications themselves, the financial aid, housing, everything. And our students don't have family resources to pull on, so they really rely on us to help them each and every step of the way.
So, Ms. Susan, when we talk about the students who want, you know, first of all, they walk the halls when they first step foot on this campus, becoming a freshman, and they're excited, what is the first thing that you do to welcome those students, to let them know what opportunities, especially those first-generation students who probably never had a family member to attend college?
Absolutely. You have to start talking about that as freshmen. You absolutely have to start telling them. And sometimes that's kind of hard to get it in their head. One of the things that I think we've added this year to that is to have our seniors start talking to our freshmen about what I wish I would have done. So we're now looking at not just the voices of the people sitting around this table, but we're looking at the voices of our students to talk to the younger generation of students and let them know it's important right now what you do every day in every class and how to plan and prepare for college.
Talking about preparedness, Ms. Ashley, we know that you're the College Success Advisor, so that word success is huge.
Yes.
So that means when that student comes in and they want to fill out that application, do you think that there are some obstacles there? So what words of encouragement and advice when that first student walks up to you and you have to hand them that application?
I think it's very important to let them know that they will be successful regardless. So we sit down and we create a plan. We create a plan where we map out the schools that are match schools for them and safety schools so that they feel comfortable. They don't have to worry about rejection.
So dealing with rejection sometimes, so we're going to talk about that, Ms. Taylor, because
okay.
A lot of them probably feel that I may not have a chance to go to college because probably my socioeconomic background, I never had a family member, and maybe college is not the environment at their home to some of our students. How do you get them to overcome their obstacles and calm their fears?
I just let them know that it's possible, that anything is possible, whether, let's say you're scared because you don't know how you're going to pay for college. We let them know that there's resources, that there's scholarships if you fill out your financial aid. We have a newsletter that has different scholarships on there, and we utilize Naviance a lot, and there's a lot of scholarships on there. So whatever reasons they're afraid of, we just let them know that everything's going to be okay and that they'll be all right once they get to college.
And see, that's what I like, that when I step into a room, I want to make sure that I have a calmness. And especially with the smiling faces that we see right here today, I know the students feel just as exciting. But you know what? There are some other challenges that somebody may fear when she talks about financial aid and, of course, you know, being able to afford college. There are some Ivy League opportunities for some of our students to be able to go to some of the best colleges and universities. And I know Westbury is really excited because you have a student right here that we'll talk to later. So let's talk about how you engage them and let you know that you can attend an Ivy League school.
Well, one of the first things is when you're talking about a top-tier school, the cost can be up to $72,000 a year. So that sounds very overwhelming and frightening. But those top schools have amazing financial aid. So if your family makes less than $60,000 a year, typically you will be completely covered with no loans. So
it works out sometimes that you can afford going away to a top-tier school more than you can afford staying right here in the state of Texas. So one of the things that we do is we talk to the kids about what it's like to transition from an environment like this to a school like that, and we make sure that that they need to have a complete and successful application is in place. So that's essays. We work with the younger kids about creating opportunities outside of the classroom to be active and engaged. Mm-hmm. And we help them package themselves in the best possible ways.
So let's talk about that financial aid. I know that some families can make up to a certain amount of money and the student can actually qualify without having any student loans. Is that correct?
That is correct. And college affordability is such an important piece of when you're looking at colleges, and it's really, really important that you understand your family's financial situation, whatever it may be, so that you can know what you're going to have to contribute towards college. Every college has on its website something called a net price calculator, so you as a family can sit down and run the numbers and try to figure out what a specific college will cost for you, and so you can make your plans accordingly and apply to those places that if you get into, you're likely to be able to afford.
So Principal Monahan, every child, every student who walked through these doors, everyone has the drive and the potential to want to attend college. Someone may not be able to qualify for an Ivy League, but there are other opportunities for local colleges and universities, correct?
Absolutely, there are, and that's what we do. It's about matching the student with the right college. So, everyone's not made for the same college, and that's why there's so many opportunities, so many colleges out there to choose from. And that's what these three ladies do right here. When Ms. Glenn spoke earlier about matching the students with the right compatibility for the school that they go to, that's equally as important. It's all the way from what the student wants to what the parent's comfortable with, because we have several parents who aren't comfortable with their students going far away. So it's really looking at that child and what's possible for them. We don't want to set them up for a school that in the end they're not going to end up going to because they weren't comfortable with that.
And let's talk about that. So Ms. Ashley, I know you deal with the student, but how does the parent involvement come in there? Because even though the student has a fear, the parent as well, because even though they may have a student that is very smart and is above the scale when it comes to their GPA and their successes right here on this campus, how do you calm that parent's fear to say, you know what, your child can go to school, so they won't have that fear or that concern that Principal Monahan is talking about because it may be too pricey or they're too far away? So how do you bring both of them together, let them know it's going to be okay?
I think for me, I'm a product of HISD. I'm actually a product of Westbury High School. So when the parents see me and they say, wow, you graduated from here, it kind of calms their nerves right away. But then I also let them know that their students, they've given their students enough to be successful. So sometimes it's okay to let go and let them be in charge of their future. And also Ms. Du, being a mother, always comes in to help out when necessary.
I say I have two biological children and 2,200 that I mother hen.
I know, yes. Right? Yes. Talking about adoption fees, all right?
Yes.
So Ms. Taylor, yes. Let's talk about you. So you remember your first day, right? When someone had to engage you about the college opportunity.
Yes.
What testimonies do you provide to your students?
Really that anything is possible, because when I first went to start college, I had to start off at a two-year school, and I had dreams of going to a four-year university, but I just didn't have the opportunity to, and so I started off at a two-year school, and then I transferred and was able to graduate from the four-year university that I wanted to. So just it doesn't matter where you start, but where you finish.
So any one of you can chime in on this next question. We talk about dealing with things holistically. Mm-hmm. When we talk about from a point of view and when we're dealing with our students, because we know in HISD, we're nearly about over 80% economically disadvantaged in HISD as a whole, and especially in the community where Westbury sits, because there's a majority of some mixes of economics here. So how do you blend it holistically and let every child know that no matter what background you come from, no matter what financial status,
that we all are in this together. Let's start with you, Principal Wanda.
I would say that that's probably a surprise for so many kids when you do tell them that. It's possible for you to go to school. Of course you can go to school. Maybe your grades aren't quite where they want to be. Maybe you don't think that you financially can do it. But it's opening their eyes and letting them see what's available to them. I think that, you know, and then there's kids who say, I don't want to go to college, but I know what I want to do. So it's our job even then to help them get into what they want to do. What's the route they're going to take? How are they going to be successful with that?
Ms. Ash. I agree. I think I always allow the kids to tell me what they want to do, and then we go from there. We never want to tell the child they must be a doctor or a lawyer, because some kids might be a welder or a plumber. So just letting them know that we're here for their success, regardless of what it may be.
And you know what? Successes are very important. So, Ms. Laura,
yes.
There's not only just the financial side, there's the housing side, too.
Sure. It doesn't end once you've been accepted. There's still a lot of things that have to happen for you to be able to go off to college successfully in August or September. So that's one of the things that we continue to do. We keep in contact with the kids. We help them fill out their housing applications. We help them get signed up for new student orientation. We help them make sure that everything is complete and that they're ready to go. And that's an extremely important part of what we do to avoid something that's called summer melt, which is that kids that have been accepted and are planning to go sometime over the summer decide not to go. And so we don't want that to happen to our Westbury kids.
So is it too late for that child, for that student, even though, you know, right now they're thinking right now and they're just becoming seniors? Is it something that's called too late for them to apply when they're in the Go Center?
No, it's never too late. The calendar can determine where you have to start because of application cycles and all of that. One of the important things that we do is want to create a message of positivity and possibility. So regardless of where you're starting, we can map out a plan for you. And that plan may be starting at a two-year school and transferring and then going on to graduate school, but we can do it and you can do it and we can help you do it.
So when we're talking about the Go Center, and go meaning it's time to get moving, it's time to set the strategy, and we need to do it now. But when I think about this word fast, I'm thinking about, you know, okay, is this something that they're talking about? Okay, you need to do it and get it done quickly. Tell me, what is fast?
So FAST stands for fees, application fees for all the colleges. A stands for applications. S stands for scores, ACT or SAT, and T stands for transcripts.
So when you think about that and getting everyone prepared, because that's a lot in there. When you talk about, you know, your fees, your test scores, the ACT and the SAT, that's actually just getting them prepared for what they're getting ready for. So when they get in it, how do you introduce them, say, this is what you need to get ready for? And so I know we talked about fears earlier, but it's a lot goes into preparing for FAST.
Yeah, there is. So we just let them know that it's something that you have to do. You can't just put it by because you need to do it for your application to get accepted.
The whole thing is overwhelming. So what you need to do is break it down step by step. Mm-hmm. So today we're just going to make an account. Tomorrow we're going to start on this. Then next week we're going to work on the essays. And if you break it down to manageable steps, then the process doesn't seem so overwhelming and so scary.
Yes. And did they mention 450 kids?
Wow, that's a lot to case manage when we talk about education. So we talk about seniors, and because they're on their way to their next step. So how early do you start getting a student ready to prepare for college? We're just talking about seniors, so do you start in 11th, in the 9th grade, or when do you prepare them?
So we've had college fairs here that have been super successful, so much more successful this year than they were last year as my first year principal. I can't compare it to anything other than that. We have college visits with Link Learning, who supports us financially to take students, and we're not talking our seniors. Seniors do go on some of the trips, but we're hitting those freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and we're having them visit college now and see what do you want to do? Where do you want to be?
Because I know HISD provide a lot of support for what you're doing, because, of course, I tell everyone, behind a great school is a great, great leader. And I know just hearing from you, you all make your follow-ups, you contact that student, you make sure that they go through the process. But I just want to applaud you on something. You all have been doing an amazing job. You have increased your application process. You have stayed on top of the students. You made sure that their fears were, you know, not even a consideration. You made sure they applied to some of the best schools. How were you able to grow tremendously on your college application process?
I think the students want it. Sure. The students really buy into that they want to go to college, and we're here and we have the resources and the support in order to be able to help them achieve that dream.
And dreams do come true, right, Taylor?
Right.
Right, Ashley?
Yes, I do.
See, when you're talking about giving back to HISD, what other way to give back than to hire one of your own? I don't know if you heard Ms. Ashley say earlier, she's a proud graduate of Westbury High School. This is what community and family is about when you're talking about Westbury. And then when you're talking about the Go Center, you're talking about a place where students can come and prepare for the next level in their life. So I want to thank, of course, Ms. Ashley, Ms. Laura, Ms. Susan Monahan, and of course, Ms. Taylor, for being with me on this first segment of On the Yard. We'll be right back.
You already live in the city. You play in the city. Why not teach in the city? Houston ISD is looking for motivated, new, and veteran teachers to join our team. HISD offers a competitive salary, support and professional development, and career advancement. Be part of a diverse and global district that's leading the nation in innovative programs. Apply now at HoustonISD.org and come teach in the city.
You're joining us right here on the yard at Westbury High School. What can we say about those Huskies, right? They're doing a lot of great things right here at this wonderful school under the leadership of Principal Monahan. There are some dynamic staff that walk the halls each and every day and making sure that our students have the best opportunity moving forward. And when we're talking about opportunities, opportunities of careers, getting ready for college, college applications, anything that you can think of, they're doing it right here at Westbury. So thinking of Westbury and thinking about the Go Center, we have some dynamic students that's getting ready to graduate and is going to be a part of the dynamic class of 2017. You know, I think they're going to be proud when they can say that I'm an alumnus of Westbury High School. So let's meet these future alumni of this great student. I want to welcome, thank you so much for joining me on the yard. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
We have with us, of course, Mr. Devontae Parker. Good morning.
Good morning.
Then, of course, we have Miss Monica Gray. Hi. And Miss Ann Pham.
Good morning.
Are you all excited to be graduates?
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about. I remember when that day, well, no, we're not going to talk about that day. That was just on a that was just on a yesterday. So let's talk about this excitement. You know what, Devontae, I want to start with you. There's a stereotype among young African-American males. There's a lot of things that some of the wrong roads that some of our males decide to take. Some decisions that some of our young African-American males try to take. What advice do you give those males? Because you are celebrating a great milestone that everyone at this school is happy about. And talk about that, too.
I just feel as though you shouldn't follow the wrong crowd and stuff. Like, as a football player, I hung around a lot of people that didn't make good choices. But, I try to get them on the right path as me because, you know, they see me doing good, so hopefully they'll be able to do good for themselves, too. But as the stereotypes, I didn't really, like, see any stereotypes facing me. So I had all the help that I had here without any problems. So,
and because of the Go Center, and they've actually helped you prepare for college, you have some great news. So what school did you get accepted into?
Yeah, I got accepted to the Cornell University.
Oh, the Cornell. So that means when we put the on it, it's supposed to be, I guess you can say, the Trinity, the A&M, right? So, you know, let's talk to you, Monica. Are you the first person in your family to graduate from college?
Actually, yes. I had my older brother who just graduated high school, and he was actually the first person to graduate high school in my entire family. And that was a very proud moment for us, and now I will be the second person to graduate high school in my family, and I'm graduating with honors, so it's like, woo-hoo.
Not just honors, you're actually the
valedictorian
of Westbury High School. So tell me, the Go Center had prepared a lot of the students here at Westbury for that next step. Tell me, what is the greatest advantage by participating in the Go Center?
They're always available for you. No matter what time, no matter what date, they'll always help you out. Like, for example, with Ms. Dew, I was trying to finish my college applications that were due the day before. We were up till 11 at night fixing, make sure everything was spotless and ready to turn in. And I feel like it's hard to get certain individuals like that. in every school that can be so flexible and willing to work with the students.
So, fam, do you think that this should be the trend in all of our schools so every student will have the opportunity to apply for college?
Yeah, I do believe that we should, like, this should be a trend for that.
Okay,
yeah.
So you're going where?
I'm going to Texas A&M College Station.
And what is
going
to be your major?
I'm going to major in biology.
Okay, so tell me the biggest plus about being a part of the Go Center.
I would say that you get motivated every time when you come in here. Like, you feel like you're like a part of the family of the Huskies, and you always feel like so supportive and so friendly with like everyone. Like, we always have like friendly attitudes toward each other, and I really love it.
And that's what Westbury is all about, is being a family, right, Mr. Devontae?
Yeah, here at Westbury, there's a lot of support and advice that others can offer you and stuff. So
when you got that letter of acceptance saying you have been accepted into the Cornell University, what was the excitement? Did you open the letter by yourself? Were there some family members around? Well, walk me through that day.
Actually, I didn't like think nothing of it. Like, when I got the letter, I didn't get the letter, I got the email. And it was kind of like, I got it like a week before. And so I told Miss Dew, and she started crying and stuff. I was like, what's going on? I know it's such a big deal, yeah, but like, I got the letter and stuff, and I decided to go there. So.
Do you realize that it is a big deal?
Yeah, I do now. Yeah.
It is a huge deal. And so you should be very, very proud. The Cornell University? Yeah, you should be very proud. So, well, tell me about Trinity. I've never heard of Trinity. Where is it located?
Well, it's located in San Antonio. It's a private liberal arts school. I always wanted to go to a liberal arts school, but they tend to be private, and I always thought, I cannot afford this. It's never a possibility for me. But working with the people in a Go Center, they're always like, you know, you should apply, you have good grades, and they offer good financial opportunity for me, and I feel like through the Go Center, that's what they helped me the most in a financial aspect, and I'm glad to say that I'll be able to afford Trinity University this fall.
What is going to be your major?
Environmental Studies.
Environmental Studies. So, Ms. Pham, you're going to A&M University. What was that day like when you knew that you got accepted into A&M?
I was like, wow. Okay, like, I do sort of expect that I will get in the college because of all the help that I get in, like, from the Go Center. But I was just like, wow, okay, I'm going to college.
I remember that day when the opportunity came for me of being a student at Cashman High School. And coming from a family that wasn't, you know, wealthy and things like that, and remembering that day when I was, you know, I played basketball, and so knowing that I received the full ride scholarship. So I know exactly what you're feeling when you get an opportunity, and the biggest thing about it, that somebody else is paying for it. So, Devontae, what's going to be your major at the Cornell University?
Oh, at the Cornell University. We're going to major in animal science.
Animal science. Mm-hmm. So what are you going to do with animal science? Tell me, what is that all about?
I want to become a veterinarian for household pets. And then, like, probably in the future, make my own business and stuff. So.
Okay. So what steps have you prepared from here moving forward to become a veterinarian? What do you plan to do in your summertime?
Well, I started volunteering at SPCA, but I had to stop that for a little bit. But during the summer, I'm going to start again. Plus, I'm going to go to Cornell summer program, so hopefully that'll help.
Okay. I have a recommendation for you. And then, you know, once it's over, you know, get my card, and then we'll talk about
right.
it. I think the Houston Zoo would be a great opportunity for
you.
Yeah,
I was looking into that, too. Yeah.
So if you ever need a reference, give me a look up. So let's talk about Monica, the valedictorian of Westbury High School. What does that feel like when you got the call, got the email that you're going to be the valedictorian?
I was in complete shock. I didn't know that it could actually be a possibility. You know, my ultimate goal was just to beat the stereotypes that, like, oh, she's not even gonna graduate high school. Oh, she'll just graduate in the bottom of her class. And in the end, that motivated me. And I just tried my hardest. And when I found that out, I just cried.
You just cried?
I cried. I couldn't believe it. I was, like, really, really excited.
And you all support one another, right?
Yeah.
One of the questions I asked one of the previous panelists, I think I asked Ms. Ashley about engaging your family. So when you found out that you was going to the Cornell University and you had to go home and tell your parents a share, what was their reaction?
Well, my mom, at first she didn't like that I was gonna be going far away, but then she thought about it because my brother's in the Army, so he's in Kentucky. My sister's gonna be in North Carolina, so another family member in New York, so she didn't mind. She said that she always wanted to go to New York anyway. So
she gonna use you to get there?
Yeah.
So what about you, Miss Monica?
Well, my mom was really, really excited. She was like, I can't believe you're graduating top of your class and you're going to a really good college. And she was very excited. Yeah, she doesn't want to let me go.
And who doesn't want to go to San Antonio?
I know.
Riverwalk, here they come. Yeah. So what about you, Miss Anne?
I would just say that my parents were so happy of me. My mom cried, and she didn't want to let me go, but I convinced her, although I love my parents.
Just tell them it's just a two-hour ride. They can get there in no time. So if you can leave any encouraging words to any students about the Go Center, what would those encouraging words be, Ms. Monica?
Well, come in here as much as you can. Come here. Most of our seniors, that they get a little shy coming in here, but please start early, fill those applications out early, and they'll be more than happy to help you on any questions you may have.
And always keep trying. No matter, like if they were busy with you, you just have to keep trying, keep coming to them all the time, every day.
Just every day.
Just every day.
Devontae?
Yeah, basically all you gotta do is come through the door. They're gonna help you with everything else, basically. Yeah.
No shutting the door like you're not welcome. So it's a welcome sign up there for everybody. Okay, so if you can give a shout out to your university and they're watching right now today, what would be their shout out, Anne?
I'm going to Maggie this year.
Yeah. Monica.
I'm going to be a Tiger. That's 2021.
All right.
How you doing, D. Cornell University? A little bit.
Talking about being there and being excited for these students, just sitting here with them, just give me the excitement. Hey, like, I want to start college all over again. You know, from being a valedictorian to talk about animal sciences and talking about, you know, all the wonderful things that they can, the doors would just be so wide. But the best way to know all the great things that's happening at the Go Center is looking at the products. You know, talking here to Monica, Devontae, and Anne, and all the possibilities. The possibilities are great for any student who wants to go to college. And we want to give a special shout out to the team of the Go Center. Because of their commitment and their dedication, the students are who they are because of them. Thank you for joining us for this segment of On the Yard. This is yours truly, Wanda Adams, your president. Talk to you soon.